Hello my dear students, welcome back to the video lesson. I am Shweta Gupta, your maths teacher, and today I am going to do the revision worksheet of lesson number 9, and the topic of the lesson is decimals. So let's get started. So children, let's begin this revision worksheet of exercise 9A. And we begin this worksheet with the first question of this exercise. And the first question is, write the integral and decimal parts of the following decimal fractions. So first we will do the A part of question number 1. Here we have the decimal fraction 10.7. So children, what is the integral part? Well, the integral part is 10. And what is the decimal part? The decimal part is 0.7. Now let's come to the next part of question number 1, which is D part. Here the decimal fraction is 175.6735. So the integral part in this decimal fraction is 175. And the decimal part, which lies on the right side of the decimal point, is 0.6735. So now children, let's come to question number 2. Write as common fractions. So we will do the C part of question number 2. Here the decimal fraction is given, which is 0.092. And we have to write this decimal fraction as common fraction. So children, first of all, let us see the number of digits in the decimal part. Well, the number of digits in the decimal part is equal to 3. Therefore, children, the denominator is going to be equal to 1000, having 3 zero, right? And so, now, the fraction or the common fraction is equal to 92/1000. And this is our answer. Now let's come to the second part, that is the G part of question number 2. Here we have the decimal fraction 78.251. And we have to change it into common fraction, or we have to write it as common fraction. Now again, the number of digits in the decimal part is equal to 3. So, the denominator is equal to 1000, having 3 zeros. And therefore, the fraction is equal to 78/251/1000, where 78 is the whole part or the integral part. So, our answer is 78/251/1000. Now children, let's come to question number 3. Write as decimal fractions. So here in this question, let us do the C part of this question. The common fraction is given, and we have to write this common fraction as decimal fraction. So children, first of all, see the zeros in the denominator. Well, here the denominator is 10, and so the zeros in the denominator is equal to 1. Therefore, position of the decimal point is equal to 1+1, that is second from the right side. Therefore, our decimal fraction is 40.2. And you can see that in 40.2, the position of the decimal point is second from the right hand side. Now let's come to the next part of question number 3, which is G part. Here the common fraction is 36/1000. So now we have to write this common fraction as decimal fraction. So let us see the number of zeros in the denominator. Well, it is 3, and therefore the position of the decimal point is equal to 3 plus 1, that is 4th from the right hand side. Therefore our decimal fraction is 0.036, and you can see that in this decimal fraction the position of the decimal point is 4th from the right hand side. Right, now let's come to the L part of question number 3. Here we have the common fraction, which is a mixed fraction, that is 60/77/1000, and we have to write this as decimal fraction. So how we are going to write? Let us see. Zeros in the denominator is equal to 3, and therefore the position of the decimal point is equal to 3 plus 1, which is 4th from the right hand side. And you know that we write the integral part on the left hand side of the decimal point. So our decimal fraction is 60.077, where you can see the position of the decimal point, which is 4th from the right hand side. So now children, let's come to the next question of this review worksheet of lesson number 9, exercise 9A, and this is question number 5. Fill in the blanks. So let us do the A part. So here we have the decimal fraction 2.78, which is equal to dash ones plus dash tenths plus dash hundredth. So you can see that in 2.78, how many ones are there? It is 2. So there are 2 ones. How many tenths are there? It is 7. So we will write 7. And how many hundredths are there? Well, it is 8. So we are going to write 8 in the blank. Now let's move to the next part of this question, which is the C part. So here the decimal fraction is 921.506. So which is equal to 9 hundredths plus 2 tenths plus 1 ones plus 5 tenths plus 0 hundredths plus 6 thousandths. Right? Now children, let's come to question number 6 of exercise 9A. Write each of these as decimal fraction. That is, you have to write in the short form. So first, let us do the B part of question number 6. 6 ones plus 5 tenths plus 0 hundredths plus 5 thousandths is equal to? Well, it is equal to 6.505. Now let's do the C part of this question. 8 hundredths plus 9 tenths plus 5 ones plus 0 tenths plus 0 hundredths plus 2 thousandths is equal to how much? If we write this in short form, it is equal to 895.002. Now children, let's come to the next question, which is question number 7. Fill in with the short form, that is the decimal form. So let's do the B part of this question. 1 plus 3 by 10 plus 5 by 100 is equal to 1.35. Now let's do the D part of this question. A plus 0 by 10 plus 4 by 100 plus 9 by 100 is equal to 8.049. Now let's come to the E part of question number 7. 400 plus 0 plus 2 plus 1 by 10 plus 3 by 100 plus 0 by 1000 plus 7 by 10,000. This is equal to 402.1307. Now let's come to the 8th question, which is write in the expanded form. So here the short form is written and you have to write the expanded form of the following decimal fractions. So let us see. Let's do the B part. The B part is 5.38. So we need to write this decimal fraction in the expanded form. So how we are going to write? Well, 5.38 is equal to 5 plus 3 by 10 plus 8 by 100. Now let's move to the next part of this question, and question number 8, and this is the E part. 450.3075. So let us see how we are going to write it in the expanded form. This is equal to 400 plus 50 plus 0 plus 3 by 10 plus 0 by 100 plus 7 by 1000 plus 5 by 10,000. So now children, let's come to the next question, which is question number 9. Write the place value of the given digits. So the first part is the B part of this question. Here the decimal fraction is given 87.396, and we have to find out the place value of the digits 8, 6, 9 and 3. So we can see that 8 is at tens place, so the place value of 8 is 80. 6 is at 1000th place, so the place value of 6 is 6 upon 1000. 9 is at 100th place, so the place value of 9 is 9 upon 100. 3 is at 10th place, so the place value of 3 is 3 by 10. Now let's come to the next part of this question, which is D part. So here the decimal fraction is 4080.0507. And you have to find out the place value of 4, 8, 5 and 7. So now children, 4 is at 1000 place. Therefore, the place value of 4 is 4000. 8 is at tens place, so the place value of 8 is 80. 5 is at 100th place, so the place value of 5 is 5 upon 100. And 7 is at 10,000th place, so the place value of 7 is 7 upon 10,000. So now let's come to the next part of this question, which is G part. So here we have the decimal fraction 0.9876, and we have to find out the place value of the digit 6, 7, 8, 9. So first of all, let us find out the place value of the digit 6. 6 is at 10,000th place, so the place value of 6 is 6 upon 10,000. And the place value of 7, which is at 1000th place, is 7 upon 1000, right? And the place value of 8, which is at 100th place, is 8 upon 100. And the place value of 9, which is at 10th place, is 9 upon 10. Now children, let's come to the question number 11. Write in ascending order, that is from the smallest to the largest. So the numbers are 21.2, 20.21, 212.01, 20.1020, and 20.201, and we have to arrange these decimal numbers or decimal fractions in ascending order. So first of all, what we will do, we will equals the number of digit on the right hand side of the decimal point. So the equivalent decimal fractions or decimal numbers are 21.200, 2000, 20.2100, 212.0100, 20.1020 and 20.2010. So now we can see that the number of digits on the right hand side of the decimal point are equal, which we have done by adding zeros. Now children, in ascending order, when we arrange these numbers, they are 20.1020, then 20.2010, then 20.2100, then 21.2000, and then the largest number, which is 212.0100. Therefore, our final answer is 20.1020, 20.201, 20.21, 21.2, 212.01. So these are the numbers which are arranged in ascending orders. Now children, let's come to the next question, which is question number 12, and this is the last question of this exercise. And the question is, write in descending order, that is from the largest to the smallest number. And our numbers are 14.335, 0.1435, 143.35, 1.4335 and 143.5. So first of all, we will equal the number of digits on the right hand side of the decimal point by adding zero. So 14.335 will become 14.3350, 0.1435 will become 0.1435, and 143.35 will become 143.3500, 1.4335 will become 1.4335, 143.5 will become 143.5000. Now it is very easy to compare these numbers and write them in descending order, that is from the largest to the smallest number. So the largest of these number is 143.5000. Then the next number is 143.3500. The third one is 14.3350. Fourth one is 1.4335. And the last or the smallest number is 0.1435. Now the answer is 143.5, 143.35, 14.335, 1.4335 and 0.1435. So these are the numbers which are arranged, or the decimal fractions or decimal numbers that are arranged in descending order. So children, this way we have come to the end of this video lesson, and I hope you have very well understood all the sums that have been explained in this video lesson. Thank you, my dear students. Keep watching, keep learning.